college. He was in the juniors at the amateur contest.
I met Craig up at First Avenue. He was glassing boards for Charlie Galento. And Ben was shaping up there too. And I lived right around the corner. After a while, he left there, went to Pearl City and started TNC, Town & Country. And I came down there and we started that. And it was great, especially when I loved the factory. After shaping all day, I go in the back, up the mountain, ride skateboard down. So it was perfect, shape and skate.
Because Larry and I were already friends, I just approached him to work something out. He agreed and we just went from there. Larry started surfing for us either 1974 or 1975. Because of Larry's notoriety, I had this image that the kids would look up to him and it would be a good image for TNC Surf. All of a sudden, he was in a lot of Surfer Magazine shots and his things with the media really helped our image. I think Larry first started influencing our surfboard sales and also our skateboards because he was sponsored by Sims and we did a lot of skateboard business with Sims. Larry introduced me to the Cadillac wheels in California.
I was still skateboarding and I ran across these. I went, oh, these are freaking unreal.
We went to Stone Steps at Ano Takayama's house. He was skateboarding and he begged me to try his skateboard. And I said, why? He said, trust me.
That's a great. You got, because we didn't have those over here in the way. You got to get these wheels. You got
to
get them.
I rode the wheels. It was so amazing. I said, I have to bring these to Honolulu.
And once he got them, this whole place just blew up.
All the Cadillac wheels and skateboards we sold funded our second store in Waimalu Plaza and our second surfboard factory. Larry introduced me to Dane Keloi, which is his wife's cousin. And it was one of the similar ones. He said, trust me. And he became to be the next Larry Bertelman. Second thing that Larry introduced me was Bla Pahanui. We made a special shirt for his dad and he wore it at a concert at NBC. And everybody asked us, wow, how did you get them to, you know, wear our Town & Country t-shirts at the concert? And we just laughed.
That red, white, and blue board was one of the first ones I made to ride smaller waves. Everybody thinks, you know, riding big waves is really hard and everything. But the hardest thing to ride isn't that 30, 40 foot wave. It's the 1 foot wave. Why? See if you can catch a freaking 1 foot wave and ride it. That board, I can catch wave. And once I suit up, I start turning, bumping, carving, creating my own speed. I could get up waves this big and I'm cruising. Everything I do is you gotta have speed. You gotta have speed and balance. That's why you gotta be low to the boards. The red, white, and blue board, it could ride like from 1 foot to 6 feet. Perfect, that's that range. The design was inspired for Coca-Cola. You made it all red, it looked like the Coca-Cola thing. But you made it red, white, and blue, think it's Pepsi. No, it's pure LB. Yeah, plus it looks like you're cutting back, rah, the slash. How I do things is, I dream. Like say for instance, Larios, that was what it was at the beginning before they changed to Aerials like everybody else. Once I could see it in my head, then I could do it. And once I could do it, then everybody else could do it. They had to see somebody say, it's possible, anything's possible. The only limits you have is the one you put on yourself.
What I'm most proud of in the last 50 years is that I made my parents proud of what I created and that the employees, that they be proud to work for us. At this point, I truly have to say I'm really blessed to be able to work and surf in this wonderful surf industry.
When I think of TNC, I think of growing. Because from nothing to what it is now. First time I heard 50 years in business, I went, oh my God, has it been that long? Where'd the time go? I think it's great. Oh, I'd just like to say thanks to Craig for helping me out with TNC and it helped me out a lot. Thank you very much.